students, continue the discussion. Today can we discuss some of the conditions of direction, cosines and direction ratios. So yesterday we already discussed with whatever the conditions of the vectors are represented in both Cartesian and the vector form. Means if p of x comma y given on the point on the two dimensional space, such a point can be represented in the vector form. It's also can be written as vector OP is equal to x into I cap plus y into j cap. That is called as vector components of the point. So p of x comma y is the scalar component and xi plus yj is called as vector component. So it already studied in the previous classes. So today can we discuss with direction cosines and direction ratios. Now again when we consider the two dimensional spaces, x, x dash and y, y dash. On the two coordinate axis, O is the fixed point. Now, P being any point on the plane, coordinates are written as x, y. P of x, y be a point on x, y plane. Join OP. Now, OP is called as position vector of a point P with respect to O, because O is a fixed point and P is an any point on the line plane. Then the line OP is called as position vector of a point P, and it's also represented in one of the vector, is denoted by vector A. So vector OP is equal to vector A. Then draw PM is perpendicular to x axis and PM is perpendicular to y axis. PM is perpendicular to x axis, PN is perpendicular to y axis. Then OM is called as coordinate of x axis and PM is the coordinate of y axis. Therefore OM is denoted by x, PM is denoted by y. Now PN is parallel to, PN is parallel to OM. Therefore PN is also equal to x. Similarly PM is parallel to OL, that is also denoted from y. Then now consider some two different angles alpha and beta. So alpha and beta are the two angles with the positive direction of x and y axis along with the vector a. Alpha is an angle made by the positive direction of x axis to the vector a, and beta is an angle from vector a to y axis. Both are represented in the positive direction, means which moves under anti-clockwise directions. Now these angles are called as direction angles. Alpha and beta are called as direction angles. Then cos alpha and cos beta, cos alpha and cos beta are called as direction cosine. Cos alpha and cos beta are called as direction cosine. Particularly angles are called as direction angles. Alpha and beta are called as direction angles. So then angles can be represented in terms of cosine of the function. Then cos alpha and cos beta are called as direction cosines. After that, from the triangle OPM. From the triangle OPM, what are the definition of cos alpha? Now, first we'll order the sides of the trigonometrical ratio. From the triangle OPM, alpha is one of the acute angle. Then OM is called as adjacent side, PM is the opposite side, and OP is an hypotenuse side. So by using the triangle, now what are the definition of cos alpha? Adjacent divided by hypotenuse, where adjacent is OM. OM is denoted by x. Therefore, cos alpha can be written as x divided by, where hypotenuse. Hypotenuse is one of the line OP. OP is called as directed line segment. Then the vectors is denoted by vector A. But it's also can be represented with the magnitude, because it's one of the vector line. So vector lines is also called as magnitude of the vector lines is denoted by modulus of E. Therefore cos alpha is equal to x divided by magnitude of A. Similarly, from the triangle OPN, from the triangle OPN, again beta is one of the acute triangle. So sides of the triangles are PN is called as opposite side, ON is an adjacent side, and OP is the hypotenuse side. So by using the triangle, again define it for cos beta. Cos beta. So definition is adjacent divided by hypotenuse. Adjacent is ON, but ON is denoted by Y. Divided by hypotenuse is OP. OP is denoted by vector N, and it's also represented with the magnitude. Therefore, cos alpha and cos beta. Cos alpha is equal to X divided by magnitude of A, and cos beta is equal to Y divided by magnitude of A. These two are will be called as direction cosines of two dimensional space. Direction cosines of two dimensional space. So then adding and squaring the above condition means what are to be called as direction cosines of the function. These functions are get adding and squaring in the result. That is cos square alpha plus cos square beta. Cos square alpha plus cos square beta. It will be equal to whatever the solution of cos alpha. Cos alpha is nothing but x divided by magnitude of A. Then the square is x square divided by magnitude of A whole square. Similarly, cos beta. Cos beta is defined by y by magnitude of A. Then the square is y square divided by magnitude of A whole square. So we get an LCM. Magnitude of A whole square is an LCM. Then the numerator is x square plus y square. But x square plus y square is called as one of the condition of magnitude of the vector. Otherwise, by using the triangle. OPM is one of the right angle triangle. By using the triangle, condition of Pythagoras is sum of square of two sides of the triangle is also equal to square of the hypotenuse side. Therefore, x square plus y square is nothing but magnitude of vector A whole square. Therefore, x square plus y square is written as magnitude of A whole square divided by magnitude of A whole square. Then both are get cancelled, it will be equal to 1. Therefore, cos square alpha plus cos square beta is equal to 1. That is one of the conditions for the direction cosine. Now, these are the conditions of two-dimensional spaces. By using the same condition, it's also represented in the three-dimensional. But it's always remember this result. Cos alpha is nothing but x divided by magnitude of A. Cos beta is nothing but y divided by magnitude of A. And standard results of sum of square of direction cosines of two-dimensional is nothing but 1. Similarly, the direction cosines are represented in the three-dimensional space. Will be considered in the three-dimensional space x, y and z axis. Let P of x, y, z be a point on the three-dimensional. Join OP. Now OP is called as position vector of a point P with respect to O. And it's also denoted by vector A. Vector OP is denoted by vector A. Then consider the three different angles. Alpha, beta and gamma are the three angles represented by the positive direction of x, y and z axis. So alpha is the positive direction of x axis to the line OP. Beta is from y axis to the line OP and gamma is from z axis to the line OP. Now, these are will be called as direction angles. Alpha, beta and gamma are called direction angles. Then these angles are represented in the cosine of the function. Cos alpha, cos beta and cos gamma are called as direction angles. Cosines. So alpha, beta, gamma are the direction angles. Cos alpha vector A. Therefore, cos alpha can be written as x divided by magnitude of E. Similarly, beta is an angle made by the positive direction of y axis. Therefore, cos beta can be written as y divided by magnitude of E. So, gamma is an angle made by the positive direction of z axis. Therefore, cos gamma can be written as z divided by magnitude of E. So, our alpha, beta, gamma are the direction angles. Then, cos alpha, cos beta and cos gamma are called as direction cosines. These are the some standard results to find the direction cosines. Now, again by using the condition of, we already know that cos square alpha plus cos square beta is equal to 1. It's already proved in the two dimensional spaces. So by using that result, now it's also can be written as cos square alpha plus cos square beta plus cos square gamma. It's also can be written as 1. Now cos alpha, cos beta, cos gamma are called as direction cosine. These are also denoted by L, M and L. Are represented in the small letters. Where L is the direction cosine of alpha, otherwise cos alpha, M is cos beta and N is cos gamma. Therefore, the above result is also can be written as L square plus M square plus N square is equal to 1. So remember these two results. Cos square alpha plus cos square beta plus cos square gamma is equal to 1. Otherwise, L square plus M square plus N square is equal to 1. Where L is cos alpha, M is cos beta and N is cos gamma. Now, these are will be called as direction cosines. So, next we will continue the direction ratio. What about the definition of direction ratio? We will consider the three numbers A, B, C and the small letters. The three numbers A, B, C are directly proportional to the direction cosines. Directly proportional to direction cosines. Corresponding direction cosine. Then the numbers are will be called as direction ratio. The three numbers A, B, C are directly proportional to the direction cosine. But direction cosines are also denoted by L, M, N. These three numbers are proportional to the direction cosine. Such a numbers are called as direction ratio. That is also can be written as A is proportional to L, B is proportional to M and C is proportional to N. Where A, B, C are called as direction ratios. But it's also defined by A is proportional to, where L, L is nothing but cos alpha. But cos alpha is also can be written as x divided by magnitude of E. Similarly, B is proportional to M, where M is nothing but cos beta. Cos beta is also can be written as y divided by magnitude of E. Similarly, C is proportional to N, where N is cos beta. Cos beta can be written as z divided by magnitude of E. Now, these are also can be written as 1 over magnitude of A into x. Similarly, 1 over magnitude of A into y, and C is proportional to 1 over magnitude of A into z. So therefore, A is proportional to 1 over magnitude of A into x, B is proportional to 1 over magnitude of A into y and C is proportional to 1 over magnitude of A into z. But what about the 1 over magnitude of A? So magnitude of vector A is called as length of the vector. Now length is always called as one of the scalar number, otherwise it's one of the constant. Length is always called as one of the constant. Therefore, 1 over A is one of the constant, that is also denoted by, put 1 over A is equal to sum of the constant by using for K. Therefore, it's also can be written as A is equal to K into X. Means to remove the proportional sign by using sum of the constant. A is equal to K into X, B is equal to K into Y and C C is equal to K into Z. So now these are the relations of direction ratio. So direction ratio is some three numbers A, B, C are called as direction ratio, but which are directly proportional to direction cosines of their corresponding. A is proportional to L, B is proportional to M, and C is proportional to N. So that's also can be written as A is proportional to x by magnitude of A, B is proportional to y by magnitude of A, and C is proportional to z by magnitude of A. But by divided by magnitude of A is also can be written as in the form of 1 over magnitude of A. So 1 over magnitude of A is one of the constant. Such a terms can be denoted by using the K. Therefore, A is equal to Kx, B is equal to Ky, and C is equal to Kz. Now, A, B, C are called as direction ratios. After that, it's also can be written as if K is equal to 1. Otherwise, suppose K is equal to 1, then A is equal to X, B is equal to Y, and C is equal to Z. These are the direction ratio. Yes, but X, Y, Z are also called as scalar component of the vector. P of X, Y, Z is one of the point on the three-dimensional. In that point, X, Y, Z are called as scalar component. So, scalar component is also equal to direction ratios when the constant is always nothing but 1. Next condition is section formula. So we'll already add that name section formula. So section means let A and B are the two points on the plane joined AB. It's one of the line. So such a line which demands the another one of the point. Now P be a point which demand the line AB either in two different cases. One of them is called as internal division. And another one is called as external division, or in the sum of the ratio M is to N. The point P which divide the line AB internally or externally are in the ratio M is to N. That condition is already discussed in the previous classes in the first PUC syllabus. But the formula for the section formula in the geometrical form P of X, Y can be written as MX2 plus nx1 divided by m plus n. Similarly, my2 plus ny1 divided by m plus n. That is called as coordinates of the point P which divides the line AB internally or in the ratio m is to n. Similarly, in the external division, P of x, y is equal to mx2 minus nx1 divided by m minus n comma my2 minus ny1 divided by m minus n. Now first we'll compare in these two results. What about the main difference? Now what are the ratios I will be? What are the ratios I m and n I will be positive? Both I will be positive. Such a division is called as one of the internal division. If any one of these two ratios are will be negative, such a division is called as an external division. So for example, in a numerical form, 5. Now 5 can be written as either 2 plus 3 or 3 plus 2 or 1 plus 4 plus 4 plus 1 etc. These types of divisions are will be called as one of the internal division. Means both are will be positive. These types of division are internal division. But that same 5 is also can be written as 6 minus 1 or 7 minus 2 or 8 minus 3 like this. These types of divisions are called as external division. So therefore the second terms of the division is always nothing but negative in case of external. Therefore put n is equal to minus n is called as external division. But in this section the same conditions are represented in the vector form. In the previous classes, can be defined, discussed in these are the Cartesian form in the coordinate points. But the same points represented in the vector form. What about that? Define the section formula in the vector form. Now, O is one of the initial point. Initial means it's always one of the fixed point. O is a fixed point. A and B A and B are the terminal parts. Both are will be terminal, depends on the initial. So O is one of the fixed point. A and B are the terminal parts. Now join AB. AB is one of the directed line segment. So it's one of the directed line segment. Therefore, we'll be choosing one of the point is called as initial, and another one is the terminal. Therefore, A can be written as the initial point, and B is the terminal. Therefore, the line which moves from A to B. Now, PB is one of the point which divides the line AB internally or in the ratio M is to N. PB is a point which divides the line AB internally or in the ratio M is to N. Therefore, vector AP divided by vector PB. Vector AP divided by vector PB is equal to M divided by N. If we call as an equation 1. So, A and B are the points on the directed line segment. PB a point which divides the line AB internally or in the ratio M is to N. Therefore, vector AB divided by vector PB is equal to M divided by N. Then these three points are joining with O. Join ON, OP and OB. Now O is one of the initial point. Therefore, all these three points are will be considered for the terminal parts. Vector OA, vector OP and vector OB are the position vector of a point A, P, B respectively. These are also denoted by vector A, vector B and vector R. So vector OA is equal to vector A. That is called as position vector of a point A with respect to O. Similarly, OB is equal to vector B. That is the position vector of a point B with respect to O. And vector OP is equal to R with the position vector of a point P with respect to O. Now, by using the equation 1, vector AP divided by vector PB is equal to M divided by N. Then the square get cross multiply. N of vector AP is equal to M of vector PB. N of vector AP is equal to M of vector PB. But vector AP is also can be written as by using the definition of position vector of a point. Position vector of AB is nothing but OB minus OA. It means position vector of the terminal point minus position vector of the initial point. Position vector of terminal point minus position vector of initial point. That result is already discussed in the previous section. So similarly, vector AP is nothing but vector OP minus vector OA, position vector of terminal point minus position vector of initial point is equal to M of. Again PP can be written as OB minus OP. So get substitute. OP is nothing but OP is equal to vector R minus OA is nothing but vector A is equal to M R. Again OP is nothing but vector B minus OP is nothing but vector R. So get distribute. N into vector R minus N into vector A is equal to M into vector B minus M into vector R. So in that expansion, what are in terms of R are in the one set and remaining A and B are in the another set. So in terms of R, minus M into vector R plus N into vector R, that we taken as in the one set. N into vector R plus M into vector R is equal to M into vector B plus N into vector A. In these two terms, vector R as a common factor. That is, R of N plus M is m into vector b plus n into vector a divided by m plus a. That is one of the condition for the internal division. So coordinates of the point p which divides the line ab in the internal division. So similarly, what about the condition of external? So external means what are the terms of second ratio can be changes with the negative. So n is positive and n is negative. Therefore, put n is equal to minus n in the above expansion. What are the result is already exist in the internal division. In place of n can be written as minus n. Therefore, vector r is equal to m into vector b plus into minus is minus n into vector a divided by m minus n. That is called as one of the external division. So these are the section form of vector in the two-dimensional space.